Here we are. This is the best of the best from e.l.f. Cosmetics. This is what I have found through the years that are just absolutely tried and true products from e.l.f. Cosmetics. e.l.f. for me is a brand that they really have stepped up their game. They are trying so hard to think outside of the box and still bring us affordable makeup, and I think that is just so fantastic. Now, I'm sure that not all of my picks will be your picks. If you guys have some e.l.f. products that I don't mention here that you just swear by, please leave that in the comment section because I'd love to hear those from you. And please give this video a thumbs up if you like seeing the best of the best from different makeup brands, because I do enjoy bringing those to you because I test out so much so that you don't have to lots of times. And always try to remember when I do these videos, it's just to inform you. I'm not like saying you have to run out and get these products. I know that we're all living through very, very difficult times right now. I just want to be able to bring you good content so that you guys can kind of take your minds off of what's going on and be a little bit distracted. And so I thought this would be a really good way to bring you something that was very affordable and that were my loves from this brand. So we're going to get into my very favorite best of the best products from e.l.f. Cosmetics right now. So I'm going to start off with e.l.f.'s eyeshadows. Now, I think that they are something next level. Now, I am not talking about e.l.f. used to have like, they used to have the little duo. I think there was duos, and then they had the 10 pan ones that were longer. This is their new formulas that I'm talking about. This palette right here, which is Earth and Ocean, and it came out, I don't know, a little bit ago. And then they have one that I haven't tried yet that I really want to. And if you guys have seen that, I think it's something about the chocolates or something. If you guys have seen that and like it, let me know. This one is so cool as far as all of these really cool tones over here. Then you got your really warm ones over here and just absolutely blends so good together. The only one that I've had any sort of a problem with is this one right here, which is a silver. It's a little bit more chunky, but I even can make it work with using some setting spray on a brush or on my finger and then going into it. I can still make it work, but I kind of have a tendency to go into these other ones because honestly, you guys, they are just so beautiful and so pigmented. And even these ones, like this one right here is a matte, and holy moly, you guys, they're so good. Blends so well, and they just are ones that I have been dipping into like crazy. And I love this palette. This particular palette just speaks my name because it has all those colors that I can play with, but it still has the very neutral or just basic colors that you can go into and pick up and really get a lot of use out of too. And then we have these new little babies that just came out not very long ago. And you guys, everybody is just going crazy for them. And there's a reason. They're really good. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on them, but if you find a color that you really like, I would say go for it. My favorite one right now is the truffles one because it does have that color that I love to put on my lid, and then it has more of the almost cool tones over here, but you do have that one basic tan brown color right there. That's such a pretty color on the eyes. I just think these are so gorgeous. Great for travel. So they're only $3 a piece, and wow, you just can't go wrong because you know, throw it in your purse. You have something that you can travel with. This one is called Rose Water, and I just think that they're so good. They've just done a really great job on the formula in here. Really highly pigmented. It just is a really good formula, you guys. I don't think you're going to be disappointed with any of those that you pick up, and they're all over the place right now. So I just wanted to throw in my two cents and say, yeah, they're pretty good. The next thing I'm going to talk about is their primers. Now, the original primer that they came out with was the mineral primer, and that one is a straight-on dupe for Smashbox Original Photo Focus. Photo Focus is Wet n Wild. Photo Finish primer. So definitely take a look at those. I have right now the Poreless Face Primer, which honestly, you guys, this is a pretty darn close dupe for the Hourglass one, their Veil Mineral Face Primer. So close. It's very silky, goes on very just soft, and it gives you that really, really poreless look on your skin. But their putty primer, that is the dupe for the Tatcha. This one is my favorite for my dry skin. It just feels different on my skin. It just feels like it has a little bit more hydrating factor to it, but it has enough of the silicone or the dimethicone that it really just makes my pores look just flawless and finished without, you know, making me too matte. So this one is probably my number one. But you guys, if you have any other concerns, you know, they do have an acne control one, and they have that other mineral one that I would highly recommend. And I know that they do have a hydrating one. I haven't tried that, but every single one of these in this bottle like this that I've tried, I've loved. I do have the luminous one in the poreless putty, which I don't like as much as the original. But so these are my two picks for their primers. So good. Can't go wrong with e.l.f. primers. Also, one of the things that I talked about years ago when my channel very first started was their makeup mist and set from e.l.f. I like this one for really setting my makeup in the summer when it's a little bit more humid and I'm a little bit more, you know, having my little menopausal power surges that I get occasionally. But they do have an illuminating one too that I haven't tried yet. So if you guys have tried the illuminating one, give me some feedback on this. But this one I've been using for years and years. I'll go out and I'll look for other ones and I'll try other ones and I like them. And then I come back to the e.l.f. one, especially during the summer. I shouldn't say that I use this during the winter when the dry heat is on and the air is so it's so dry. I don't use this in the winter, but in the summer, I definitely use this one. So that's been a staple of mine for a really long time. And then I very recently in another video talked about this little quad right here, which is the contour palette from e.l.f. And I love this contour palette for so many reasons. Number one, I got a lot of comments from you guys saying, I didn't know that you could pop out those little pans on those. You can. You can take these little pans from any of these e.l.f. quads and you can just pop them out and then you pop them back in and then you can have yourself your own little customized palette. They have several of these out and I'll show you in a second what I'm talking about. But what I love about this is that contour color right there is one of the best contour colors I've ever found. It is deep enough that you can, you know, really carve out a cheekbone or, you know, kind of hide the high forehead or the chin or whatever you're doing. But it doesn't have so much orange in it that it's going to look like you've got a streak of orange instead of just a receding contour color. I also love the other colors in here. This one is more along the lines of a bronzer color. This one is more along the lines of a highlighting color. And then just a regular like banana powder, which I really love. This is a powder that if it's, this is in my purse and I don't have powder and I need to touch up, that powder will do me every time. And actually, if I just mix the two of them together, I almost have something like the Milani Prep Set and Glow that everybody is going nuts over right now, which most of us have been using for years. But if you just swirl between the two, you really have something like that and you can touch up with it too. So love the e.l.f. contour palette. This is probably my third one, maybe. I don't know, something like that. But they also have this Total Face palette and you're gonna see, okay, I took one of them out and this was another one that I had, another one of the contour colors that I had from another palette. And then I just used these ones over here. So this is a really super light blush. If you're medium to deep skin tone, this is not gonna work for you. This works for me in the winter. And then you have like just kind of almost, I'm gonna say it, it's almost an hourglass powder, you guys. And then this one is supposed to be the bronzing color. So this is a really super light palette, but if you like hourglass powders, and I don't even remember what goes over here because it's been a while since I switched this out, but if you really like hourglass powders, the ambient lighting powders, and you swirled in all four of those from the original one, you really have really close powder to that. In texture, in the quality of it, the blendability of it, how it just doesn't show any texture whatsoever, and it just gives the most beautiful look across your face. And again, this is the Total Face palette, and like I said, you can switch those out. That's what that is I've switched one out. So definitely, you know, look into these palettes. I think they've gotten lost after time in the shuffle of, you know, we get so much going on with makeup releases, but I love these little palettes and I will continue to purchase them and I hope they never discontinue them. Okay, two powders that I want to talk about. First of all, if you are an oily skinned gal, the Perfect Finish HD powder, this one is fabulous. If you love the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Pores powder, this one is almost along the same exact lines as that. It has such a pretty texture when you delve into it with your finger. And then when you put it across your face, if you are oily through any of these breakthrough areas, it's going to help you with that oil and keep that oil at bay. Also, pore refining, fantastic. But as far as it just being a good powder, you guys, when I stick my finger in there, I feel like that is a super high-end powder and a wonderful compact. And they did a really great job on the way they did it. I've since lost my little puff that goes in there. But I love that you can throw that in your purse and you have that little puff and you can use it just as a touch-up powder through the day, as well as this one, which is the Sheer Tint Finishing Powder. And they, again, took their cue, per se, this is the Fair Light one. They took their cue from the It Cosmetics line. But you guys, this is a powder that I use almost daily. I really love this powder. It is such a good powder for blurring out my mature skin, my pores, my texture, all of that. It just makes my skin look finished and my makeup set down so nicely. And it's not drying as the one that is the HD powder. So if you have oily skin, you're gonna probably really love this one. But if you have dry skin like I do, this is a great one. Now, as far as their loose powders, I'm not crazy about those. I have found that they just dry me out so bad. And even some of my oilier skin gals that I've talked to have said that that powder doesn't work that well for them either. You either really like it or you really don't. But these two powders right here, the Sheer Tint Finishing Powder and the HD Powder, are so good. And it has both of us covered, whether we're dry skin or whether we're oily. So somewhere in between, just pick your, whether you want a little bit of extra finish or whether you just want that translucence that the HD finishing powder would have just as a regular powder. I want to mention two of my workhorse brushes. These are brushes that I use every single day, no matter what I'm doing, no matter what makeup I'm using. These two brushes come out, and it's the e.l.f. Small Stipple Brush. I love this brush because it is small enough that I can do all of my precision work, and that is usually to carve out my cheekbone. So I stipple across my contour right here along where I'm getting a saggy jowl, and you know, on the chin right here, and I just stipple it out. And the stippling motion seems to be so much better for me than the brushing, because wherever I brush, it has a tendency to, right the first place I laid it, to be a ton of color, and then I have a hard time blending. I don't have a problem with that with this. And I was turned on to this by Emily Noel probably 6-7 years ago, and I love this thing. It's such a good little brush. I think it's like $3 or $4, so can't go wrong with that. And then this brush I discovered last year. This is my favorite powder brush that I have. This is just a large, let's see if I can read this on here, just says powder brush, e.l.f. powder brush. But I love this. It is a dupe for one that I have that I got from It Cosmetics that costs a ton more, probably triple more or more. This one I think is $12, and the one that I have from It Cosmetics, I believe, is in the $30 to $35 range. So this one is so soft and so nice, and I could not have my e.l.f. favorites or the best of the best in e.l.f. without having this brush in there, because it's in my hand every single day to do my makeup. I just love this thing. There's a couple of new things that I picked up from e.l.f. that I'm really impressed with, and I want to tell you about them right now. And I'm not going to spend a lot of time on them, but I really do like them and think they're beautiful. This is the Lip Plumping Gloss. I just think this is so pretty. This is all I have on today, along with a lip liner. And it's a sheer gloss with a little bit of iridescence in it, and I just think it's so pretty. And it does the same effect on my lips that the Buxom do. It's not quite as intense as the Buxom, but it still has that, you know, that little bit of that menthol or eucalyptus or whatever it is in there, camphor, whatever it is in there, that gives you that cooling effect that you get. And I really do like those, and the colors are really pretty on that. This one I really like from e.l.f. too. This is a multitasking stick. So you can use this on your cheeks, you can use this on your lips, whatever, your eyes, whatever you want to use it on. This is such a creamy blush, and that's what I have on today, you guys. I just have really fallen in love with this. It's got a great texture. It clings to my cheeks all day long, so I don't have a bunch of fading during the day. And when I use a stipple brush, I don't ever use my cream products without using a stipple brush. It just goes on just gorgeous, and I don't feel like it's hard to blend out. And I love the texture of it. It doesn't show up any of my mature skin's texture, which I like about it too. And this color is Sparkling Rose. And when it says it's Sparkling Rose, you would think that it has some sort of shimmer in it. It doesn't really. I think it just has a beautiful satin effect on my skin. So really, really enjoying that one. And then everybody went nutso over the original e.l.f. concealer. And this one that is the hydrating one, I am now over the moon in love with this. This is what I'm wearing almost every day right now. And I just really like it. I like the way that it sets down. I'm going to just put a tiny bit on this little beauty blender that I'm using right here and kind of just do that a little bit. But I like the color of it. The color of it is really good. And I like how well it blends out. And I'm just going to just kind of show that to you really quickly right here. And you can see, you'll see the difference between my two eyes because this is just kind of a touch up after having it on. I've been in front of these lights filming for a while. So after that happens, I feel like my makeup starts to melt. But isn't that pretty on the difference in those two eyes? Just really, really pretty. So I'm just going to put a little bit more over here from the same amount that I took originally. I just feel like it's a really good concealer for somebody that has dry, mature, crepey under eyes. And you do have to set this though, I do anyway, because when I get a hot flash, I'm finding that I really have to do something in order to be able to keep this from not creasing or anything like that. But I love it because it's super hydrating and my under eyes are such a dry area on my face and I struggle with them all the time. So I like this one so much better than the original because the original just made me look like a dried out cakey mess and I couldn't do that. So my last three products are products that came out fairly recently. I would say they probably came out last year, maybe in 2018, but it is the primer infused bronzer, the primer infused blush, and then their new highlight that they have. I have shown this in my favorite blushes from the drugstore before because you guys, this is so creamy. Every time I stick my finger in there, I'm like, whoa, this is such a nice blush. And because it has the primer, it just really hugs your cheeks and it's gonna stay there all day. And on e.l.f.'s website, not like on Ulta, I think they only have four colors. At Walmart, I think they only have two colors. But on the e.l.f. website, they do have like eight colors. And then they just came out with some shimmering ones too. So I'm gonna actually try those shimmering ones out for you guys and see what I think about them. You guys might have more where you're at, but as far as where I'm at, there really isn't that many. This one is in Sunkissed. It's the bronzer. It's the lighter one. I really do appreciate this one again because of the primer infused and it doesn't like go bam, it's a bronzer. You know, sometimes when I get a bronzer and my fair skin and I go ahead and try to put it on, it's just not going to blend in well enough and it's gonna all of a sudden just make me look super orange. And that's not what this does. It's just really pretty. You can blend it out, buff it out. It's really soft. And again, it's that primer infused formula so that you can, you know, have it on all day. It just doesn't mess with any of the other makeup. Actually, if you have that blush and the bronzer on during the day and you have a really crappy foundation on, you're gonna find that your blush and bronzer look great, but your foundation is melted away. So I really do love both of those. And by the way, this one is always rosy on the actual blush. And I wanted to make sure I told you guys that. The last product is the highlighter. And I have been absolutely in love with these new highlighters. They're so pretty, you guys. I think they only have a couple colors right now. Maybe online they have more. I will look into that. But I really do love this. I think it's so pretty and so beaming. And for me, it doesn't show up a lot of texture because when I use highlighter, I only use it right there. And I don't really use it anywhere else. I don't buff it all over my face. If I'm gonna use some sort of a highlighter all over my face, it's gonna be the Essence Pure Nude. That's really a very soft one because on my mature skin, if I get crazy with the highlighter, I'm gonna be in trouble. So I really have loved using this one. I think that it's one that is just gorgeous on the cheeks. It can be built up. And I just think that it's one of those ones that everybody can wear and everybody can love. So that highlighter is our standout product. So those are my favorites from e.l.f., the ones that have stood out to me, and a lot of them have stood the test of time, and a few of them are brand new, but I can tell you right now that they are awesome products. So I hope that you did enjoy this video. Please give it a thumbs up. I hope you all are hanging in there. I know that it's tough right now. Please take care of yourselves. Thank you so much for spending a bit of your day with me. I love you so much, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys.